Welcome to Logic First. In this video, let's learn about conditional operator or ternary operator in C language. This operator is nothing but a short form of representing an if-else condition. Say for example, if you have a simple program like this using an if-else, just to find out the bigger of the two numbers A and B. So if A is greater than B, we are assigning A to max. If not, we are assigning B to max. This is a very simple if-else condition, right? This can be replaced by a simple one-line code like this. Here, this is the expression that we are checking, A greater than B. After placing the condition, you just have to give a question mark. If A is greater than B, we should assign A. If not, we should assign B to max. If you see here, we are just using a question mark and a semicolon to represent the conditional operator here. First, we are giving the expression that we have to check and then a question mark. If this expression is true, then this will be evaluated. If it is false, the one following the colon will be evaluated. So in this case, if A greater than B is true, max will get the value from A. If it is false, max will take the value from B. So in general, you can write the syntax of conditional operator something like this. First, you are giving an expression to evaluate. If that expression is true, we can give another expression here. When we say expression, it can be as simple as a variable or it could be another mathematical expression. Then you have to give a colon to give expression 3. So if the first expression is true, the expression 2 will be evaluated. If the first expression is false, expression 3 will be evaluated. It is not advisable to use conditional operators for nested ifs or else if ladders. It will just become too complex to debug. And the code will not be much readable also. So just for simple if condition, you can go for this kind of ternary operator. Say for example, you have the input mark from the user. If the mark is greater than 50, you want to assign the grade as P. And if it is less than 50, you should assign grade as F. So we have an integer called mark and a character variable called grade. We ask the user to enter mark and we can scan it and store it in the variable mark. So if you want to go with the usual if-else condition, what you have to do is just to check if mark greater than 50. So let's assume that the first case is greater than or equal to 50. So when mark is greater than or equal to 50, you just have to assign grade as P. If not, you have to assign grade as F. This is the usual if-else condition, but if you want to replace this with a conditional operator, what you have to do is just put the expression first, mark greater than or equal to 50. If the mark is greater than or equal to 50, the grade is going to take the value of P. If not, the grade is going to take the value of F. So you are assigning this entire thing to grade on the left hand side. So first this expression gets evaluated. If it is true, then P will be assigned to grade. If it is false, then F will be assigned to grade. See here we are assigning grade equal to P directly, but instead in conditional expression, we are giving the variable on the left hand side and within the conditional operator here, we are just placing the value to be assigned, P or F. Only that is placed here. Now let's write a final program to find the minimum of three numbers using ternary operator. As I mentioned before, it is not advisable to convert a nested if into a ternary or the conditional operator because the code will not be easily understandable. But still, let's try to learn it just to gain expertise over this ternary operator. While learning about nested if, we already wrote a program to find the greatest of the three numbers using this usual nested if. If A greater than B and if A greater than C, max is A. If not, it has to be C. So we are going to use the exact similar logic here. Just that instead of greater than, we just have to check for less than, because we have to find the minimum number here. So here I am just changing the relational operator to less than. And this will now become a program to find the minimum of the three numbers. Let's change the variable name as well. Just to sum up how this works is, out of the three numbers A, B and C, if A less than B is true, it means that B is not the minimum number that we are looking for. It has to be either A or C, because A is less than B. So now, again, we have to compare A and C in order to decide which one is the smaller. So that's why we are comparing A less than C here. If this is true as well, then A has to be the minimum number, right? If not, the minimum number has to be C. So coming to the else part, this else comes into picture only when this condition is false. If A less than B is false, it means that out of A and B, B is smaller. So obviously A cannot be the minimum number that we are looking for. So we now have to compare B with C. During that comparison, if B is found to be smaller, if this is true, it means B is smaller. So min will take the value from B. If not, it will take the value from C. Alright, now let's try to write the exact same thing using conditional operator here. So now the first condition that we have to check is whether A less than B, right? If that is the case, we are going to assign everything to the minimum here. So let's write min on the left hand side. So if A less than B is true, we should concentrate on that in this part of the code. If not, we should place a colon and concentrate on this else part here, right? Now, if A less than B, if that is true, we are again checking if A less than C, right? Only if this is true as well, we can assign A to minimum. If this is false, we have to assign C to min. Alright, now we have completed this block of code. Coming to this part, which gets executed when A less than B is false. We know that when A less than B is true, this entire part of the code gets executed within this square bracket. Actually, we are not supposed to write square bracket. I just wrote it for understanding here. So if this condition is false, we need to work on that after this colon. So here we can write this part of the code by checking whether B is less than C. If that is the case, then min has to be B. If not, min has to be C. So that's it. This is the code that we are looking for. I will leave the link for the program in the description box. So this is the expression that we discussed. I just have omitted the parenthesis because it's not required in this case. If we run the program, we are asked to enter three numbers. Let's enter 5, 1 and 8. So the min value is 1. We are getting the expected output. Let's just try to find the output for these two expressions. So here first we have 5 less than 10. 5 less than 10 is true, right? If it is true, then this will be evaluated, or we have 7 here. So this entire expression will return the value of 7. If you want, you can assign this to a variable, or you can put this entire thing inside a printf as well to check what it returns. So here, since this expression was true, 7 will be returned by this expression and this 8 will be ignored. Okay, now coming to this expression, 7 not equal to 10. 7 not equal to 10 is true, right? If this is true, we just have to check this part of the code, because only if this is false, the code after this colon is taken into consideration. But here we just have to concentrate on this part of the code. Now, again, evaluating 2 and 0. 2 and 0. This is a logical operation being performed here. If you are not familiar with this operation, please check the video about this. I will link it in the suggestion and in the description box. The logical operators always take the input operands as either true or false or 1 or 0 only. We know in C all non-zero numbers are taken as true and only 0 is taken as false. So this is false and this is true. So true and false, the result is false because this is an AND operation. The logical AND of 1 and 0 is always 0. So here this expression is getting evaluated to false. So the code after the question mark is skipped. So this 2 will be returned by this expression. I have put both the expression inside a printf. If we check the output, we can see that 7 is returned for the first expression and 2 for the second expression, just as we predicted. Thank you for listening.